After playing pro sport at the highest level, building a multi-million dollar property portfolio by the age of 30, then turning that passion into a buyer's agency business in which I was nominated as Gold Coast Entrepreneur of the Year, I realized being an athlete, scaling a business, and buying property all have key similarities. These videos are my way of sharing some of the key lessons I've learned on the journey. This is Buying Gold Coast.
Alright, 6 a.m. Goldie Airport, 10-hour power trip to Sydney. Got a few good little growth catch-ups down there, a bit of learning as well. So it's going to be a quick little fun trip to Sydney. Let's go.
Your own, the goat. I got the smallest book on the bookshelf because I knew I could pump it out. What are you reading, bro?
Oh, already to 80 with the
stuff. Don't cry, miss you when I was 14. Pussy like morphine, drip like a IV, need a main line. And I try to keep this shit going and going and go. Love what I do, so I'm
all right, just touched down in Sydney, coming from sunny Gold Coast. Freezing, I didn't bring the suit jacket. First stop today, we're gonna go see Mark Boris. Really idolized him for a long time. I used to watch him on The Apprentice, so it's gonna be surreal meeting him in person, so jumping on a podcast with him, but also want to pick his brain around business and, you know, any tips he has. So that'll be awesome to meet him and sponge and learn off him. So I'm just gonna try and find a jumper, man. It's freezing.
There's a better than getting there and then ordering the Uber.
Right, what's the update up, bro?
Where's the private limo, man?
Come on, man. What's doing?
Right before Marky B, just stopping in for a quick coffee. Also, just trying to move a few deals along. It's Monday. We had a few inspections for clients on the weekend. We went under contract on an off-market property, and there's two other. One's an off-market and one's an online property. Two of those properties, two different clients. We're getting really close. We're in the negotiation stage. So what I always tip to buyers is break down the process. I think of like eating a salami. I heard it in a book somewhere, but you want to really chop it up into bite-sized pieces first, and then on the same time. Thank you very much. You want to break down the deal to each segment. So I'm just chopping up the deal into small pieces, having those crucial conversations for all parties. You know, I've got my client, I've got the agent involved, and then the next steps, I need to delegate my team to be able to push this forward and try to get the best result for our client. So yeah, let's sneak a few calls in before Marky B. Yeah, good mate, how are you?
Good, man. Happy Monday.
Happy Monday, mate. Happy Monday. Yeah. I guess good news first, we've got them engaged on paper. We're moving from a letter offer to a formal. Reesey will update you with the details and he'll request the contract. Thanks, mate.
Review time. What are you getting?
I only hit one coffee a day. This is actually my second, so the 3 a.m. wake up, I might need a little something. So I'm always long black, man. Coffee through a straw.
Oh no.
Protect the teeth, man.
How is it? Flavor? Oh, trading?
That's a 3 out of 10, man. That's hit hard. That's heavy.
Oh, God.
Just going to see old Marky B. I feel like a little fanboy.
Could try them things in the next 6 months, cut those strings, cause I always fall in love with a first time thing. In the first 2 nights, I'ma show y'all things. In the next 4 weeks, we could try them things. In the next 6 months, cut those strings, cause I always fall in love with a first time thing.
I still want love when the stakes so high. I won't let you down again, promise I won't lie. Mistakes I'm never proud of, I know that you know why.
Alright, Marky B, the man, that was cool. It was really good to meet him. I felt like a little fanboy. I spoke around footy. Like Stuart, I know he's a big Roosters fan. Super grateful with opportunities in this job that it's created. And yeah, super stoked I got to meet one of my, I guess I'd call him a mentor. He doesn't know, but I definitely look up to him. So that was really epic.
All right, just on our way to Alexandria, catching up with Dylan Mullen. Mate, he's a legend. I love his content. I love his stuff. He's a high performer in his space. So it'll be cool to jump on his potty, Life, Money and Love podcast. Check it out. It's actually a really good potty. So we're jumping in, and I really want to pick his brain around business as well. So I'm super excited for that. But before we head there, I thought I'd sneak in. We got a deal on the line, another one. I'm about to make an agent call. Really trying to close the gap and talk around some next steps, trying to get this off market done for our clients. How are you?
Good, buddy, good. Reese just called me then to send him through a contract, so I'm going to flick him through in the next 10 minutes and see what we can do.
All they want to see is we've got a genuine seller off market, you know?
Yeah.
And then what that will do is get them engaged on this one, and then, yeah, I'll try and work with you to try and get it done. Definitely not wasting time, let's put it that way.
Okay.
I'll get the team onto the contracts and then we'll make a few calls back and forth.
Sounds good, buddy.
Sweet. I'll chat to you.
Thanks, mate.
Bye, mate. Reel it in. I got the bag. Tell a friend. She got some ass. Bring it in. Bitch, I'm the new CNN. Yeah. Reel it in. I'm just about to jump into a meeting. Mate, long story short, he's staying pretty firm, mate. Let's leave it at that.
All good, man. I'll let the seller know.
All right, legend, appreciate it.
Niggas got me living. Wow. You Jordan a Pippin. I'm Kobe, I'm never gonna dish it. I'll miss it.
Who doesn't know Matt, really cool story. A portfolio of your own, top 1% property investors in Australia, and build obviously a seven-figure business.
Soul can't change, and I'm tired of being humble, bitch, I feel no way. It's that young nigga shit, I might pull up to your bitch, like...
Right, just finished with the big fella, Dylan Mullen. Epic potty, man. We went deep in that one. Business, found some insight into this e-commerce brand, but also touched on a bit of property stuff as well. So can't wait for that one to drop. Now, we got lunch, catching up with one of my old teammates. He's with the Parramatta Eels now. He's a professional athlete, but he's also actually a property investor. So yeah, big Joey Rankin, chauffeured up, here he is. Let's go, say g'day.
Oh,
God.
What's
big, dog? What's big, dog? Reel it in. I got the bag. Tell a friend. Known Jordan for a long time. He's a professional athlete. He's been debuted at 16. He's a veteran now, but he's just chatting a bit of property investing. Had three in the portfolio. He's sold one. He's looking at his next one again, so it's always good to chat property. But as an athlete, you know, coming to the back end of your career now, like, why are you sort of looking at property?
I think there's a bit of conjecture around how much we pay. I think people think that you sign a contract and you're automatically on 500 grand and
Billy Slater's salary.
You're set for the next 10 years because that's how long your career lasts, but that's not the case. I've been playing for 16 years and the best money I earned was playing overseas. I've been in the property since 18, 19, so I bought my first property. Not out of luck, but I was brought up among five. House to house. So when I turned 18, when I got my first big decent contract at the Titans, I said I wanted to buy her house so she didn't have to move around anymore. That's where I did. I think I was in my 19th birthday. I signed all the property that I bought at Elmore and I've still got it today. So it's done some wonders for me over the last 10 or so years that I've had it. And it's enabled me to go again into other properties. And then my most recent one that I bought in WA as well.
Still fit though.
I'm trying my best. Now looking into what's next after footy, and you get to a stage in your career where you need to start thinking about what that looks like.
Right, last piece of advice, any, I guess, NRL guys or athletes who are starting their career, what would be your advice to young Jordy Rankin?
Get in as early as you can. No point trying to time a market. You look too much detail, you know, you get that analysis paralysis. You've got to get in. You've got to get in as early as you can, facilitate it, because the longer that you stay in the market, the more benefit you're going to see from that.
If you're a young NRL athlete right now, finally making some money, don't be spending at the nightclub.
Don't be spending at surfers.
Like, I remember, man, you're a good saver, so don't be wasting your money and put it towards an asset, because your career's pretty short.
Your career's really short, life is long. Make sure that you've got your ducks in a row first, have some fun along the way down.
It's been a big day. I'll make a few calls to the team. I've got a few deals on the line, so I'll move them along and then wrap it up.
Hire the Jetstar chicken
for
the short ball.
Oh, man, quick little side story. Our flight got delayed. What was it? 8 p.m. We're supposed to arrive in. We tried our luck. We asked the front desk, was there any chance of moving our flight earlier? Long and behold, 4-hour sort of wait in between. So the key lesson there is be respectful to the front desk people. That's number one. And secondly, you just got to play what's in front, man. You just got to...
Eyes up footy.
You got to play eyes up footy. All right, easy, man. I'll chat to you. See you, mate. Bye. Reel it in. I got the bag. Tell a friend. She got some ass. Bring it in.